Now, what he'd be doing is he's sitting on here, and his son would be on that stool there watching every move he makes. And he'd be operating these until that white pointer comes level with the first steam of coal, on goes the brake, off goes the steam, job done. But I'm just setting it the way to show you it is still working. Well, that ring should be really forcing up and down.
Yeah.
What the whole 16 feet. That's good for demonstrating the first one. Well, the joint just won't go anywhere because they're that soft to go.
His job was to keep these men to plug them. So once they're filled, then he had to put them back out on it. He pushed them out and got what we call the flat or mini land away, which we can poorly drive. Maybe a young lad, 14, 16 year old, he would take the tubs, pull the tub off them and give them a drumming, which is never done. Then he took the main land as I say, as well. We all come together and hold up the shop for them. Put down the shop of a drift mine by a machine like that one. That's how it goes. And Collier was got paid by the tool. They did nothing, they got nothing. Hand putters, they were paid by the score of tubs they pushed out. That's how they got paid. Pony drivers, they got paid by the day. No matter what they did, they still got paid. So we're going to go underground and we'll walk in the middle because that is the highest point. The lowest point down here is 4'6". That's keep your hat on at all times. I've got mine on. This one's really quick, yeah.
Friggin' ain't it?
Catch a little bit off over now.
Thank you.
Thank you.